want to change the subject, but people talk about you and they're talking about, well, what is he doing with that money? He's doing the campaign, raise money to book.
Oh, man.
And that's what I'm trying to say. But they don't ask that about when they pay them tithes to the
no, they don't.
Every week.
No, they don't.
They don't say nothing about their pastor riding down in the big fat Cadillac.
They never ask the rappers. They don't go to the rappers and say, what you do with all the money we do with our ticket sales? I ain't never seen them down at the school board meeting asking the school district of Philadelphia, what you doing with my tax dollars? But soon a black man say he wants to raise money and do something positive. Now we need a business plan. We need a curriculum. Nigga ain't even gave me got a GED. Talk about he need to review my business plan. Get the hell out of here.
That's right. They did the same thing with the millionaire. What the nation of this not doing all that money?
Yeah.
I gave, and I don't care. They could have used my money for wallpaper, as far as I'm concerned.
Absolutely. And the argument don't stop, Brother Dave, because now that I got the school, now they say, well, is it really his? How long he going to take to open it? You understand me? Why the lights ain't on? Yeah. Of course the lights ain't on because I'm waiting for the electrician to do the full inspection, because if I turn that electric on and start a fire, we ain't going to have no school.
As a matter of fact, situation where they were talking about the beloved John F. Kennedy.
Yeah, it's not about individual slander or worship. It's about systems. I focus on systems. Just like you got a lot of black people now talking about Donald Trump or what Donald Trump don't do. Don't make this about a personality. That's what they want you to do. Because if you limited this to a personality and you ignore the evil of the system, all they got to do is switch Trump out, switch somebody else in, and you'll think it's doing better when it's doing the same thing. It's not the person in the office. It's the office itself. The presidency. The personality don't matter.
You can take Donald Trump out, put in Mike Pence, and what's going to be any better?
Exactly.
You know,
or Cory Booker or Bernie Sanders or whoever else. Nothing will change. When you vote for the president, you are voting for a personality, not a policy. The policy is already set.
Which exercise is institutionalized racism.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I'll say it's amazing. So, Colin, did you have something else you wanted to say?
Wait.
Okay.
The reason why I asked that, I'm not part of whatever the other caller was talking about.
Okay.
The reason why I ask that is because, for some reason, especially how I grew up, people praise John F. Kennedy the same way they praised Obama. So what I'm saying is, Obama, like John F. Kennedy, was just the most president too. I'm trying to say that in all the discussing each role, like Bill Clinton, how he played a role in the destruction of blacks, I'm touching on what role did John F. Kennedy play? Because no one that I know, even at that time, has criticized John F. Kennedy like that. Like, he got swept under the rug. That's what I'm asking.
I agree with you. He was also a manipulator of black emotion. But, of course, he was murdered, and LBJ took his place, and LBJ was also a manipulator of black emotion. Mm-hmm. Let me say this. One of our weaknesses as a people when it comes to politics, we have to like you personally in order to vote for you. That is a very bad political practice of black people. I do not have to like you to do business with you. I do not have to like you to vote for you. Business and politics is about getting resources and opportunities, concessions for exchange. When I go into your store, I ain't got to like you to buy that automobile. I'm paying for a service or a product. Black people have to eliminate this personalization of politicians to the point that you can get over on us if we like you or play to our emotions. I can hate you and still vote for you if we agree to exchange on the things you need for what I need. Take the emotions out of it.
That's right. That's why when I go to, sometimes I'm guilty. Sometimes I go to these Dominican stores and our women say, hey, Poppy. I said, oh, why you going to call that man Poppy?
Right.
Hey, Mama. Hey, Mommy. I was that ain't your mama.
That's right. That's right.
But anyway, because they think, well, maybe they don't like me. They like me. They don't like you. I ain't saying they don't like all of us. But that's what else they, you know, they don't. If they have a white person has a black neighbor or a coworker, they say, oh, I like Mr. Jones. He's a nice guy. I just don't like all the other ones.
Yeah.
That's what it is.
I was at a movie theater. I saw a white lady walk up to the only brother working behind the concession stand selling the popcorn.
Yeah.
And he was very stoic, very straight-faced.
Right.
And she said, oh, I like you. And I didn't like it because what it felt like was an energy of maternalism,
mm-hmm.
where I need to approve of your black existence
mm-hmm.
in my place of business.
Mm-hmm.
I don't like that. And white people have a habit of talking about what black people they like as opposed to which black people they don't like. Because if you like him, then you don't like us. Not that we care, but why did you feel we needed your validation in the first place?
Yeah.
I don't go around saying, I like you.
Yeah.
It doesn't make a difference to me.
It'll make a bit of a difference. You know, we like ourselves. At least we're supposed to like ourselves. Too many of us don't like ourselves.
Absolutely.
Too many of us don't like who we are. I had a sister the other day. I wrote to her and I said, would you be interested in going to Africa next year? She said, I never wanted to go to Africa. I said, would you rather go to the Dominican Republic? I said, where people are falling off like flies. I said, you know, there's more people dying in Philadelphia and more people dying in the Dominican Republic than they dying in Africa. I said, we staying five. And what? What
right.
is it that you don't like about Africa that makes you not want to ever want to go to Africa?
Right, but they'll go to Europe in a heartbeat. Greece, France,
yeah.
Britain, Paris.
Yeah.
Negroes love they slave masters. Black people are in love with white folks, and they do not want to admit it. We are in love with white people.
Yeah, that's amazing. So, anyhow, you got something you want to say, Eric? I mean, Patrick?
I want to also ask, going back to the schools.
Yeah.
The schools?
Yes, sir.
What are the philosophies, or what is the philosophy on which these schools are being established, and what are your expectations for the student that you are actually educating?
Yes, sir. Great question. The Frederick Douglass Marcus Garvey Academy is going to be a departure from the current paradigm of education in America. Most schools today are college preparatory academies. Their job is to simply get your child accepted into a college. For me, that is too low of a goal for me to set. Why? Because colleges are businesses. Any child with a GED can get into a college. Any child with a diploma can get into a college. So to say that I exist to get your child accepted to a college doesn't do anything for me, because they all can get in. When you see these schools that say 100% of our kids got accepted to college,
right?
And
right.
all the kids will get accepted to college because colleges need your money.
Right.
They're businesses.
They're
FDMG is a nation-building institution. We're not just about getting the kids into college. We want to create black gods. We want to create black entrepreneurs. We want to create black masters of black community empowerment and leadership. Six key sciences make up the curriculum sound work of the FDMG. Agricultural and agronomical. They will learn how to grow. How to test the soil. I want them to be George Washington Carvers in the fifth grade.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Political and military science. I want them to understand white supremacy, how it operates. Why is Africa the richest continent in the world, but the people are in the most impoverished condition? Why are one out of every four black men in the mass incarceration system? Why do black women out educate and out earn their black men? And was this systematically done? Okay, why is Jesus still white in the black community after 400 years?
Mm-hmm.
So there must be a political and a military science curriculum. And on the military side, we will be teaching combat. Oh, yes, we will. With weapons and without weapons.
Mm-hmm.
Both with arms and without arms. There will be a Marcus Garvey Jr. Gun Academy.
Mm-hmm.
We will have an archery academy. We will also have a knife academy for self-defense. We must teach our boys that there's nothing wrong with having a gun if you know how to use it.
Mm-hmm.
There will also be the science of African spirituality and cosmology. They will learn Ifa. They will learn Dogon. They will learn Kemet. They will learn the Ashanti system. All of the great rich spiritual traditions of Africa, they will study. I'm an Ifa devotee. I want them to understand all the ways we worship God and dealt with the ancestors and tapped into the Loas, the Abusums, the Netzers, and the Orishas. The next one is science of the black man and the black woman and the black community. I want them to understand their body, the connection to the Most High. I want them to understand the female's body. Become the someone that other people work for.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
And I'm going to be the African and black history teacher.
That's great.
I'm not giving that to nobody.
Yeah.
That's me.
Yeah.
Because people are sending their children to my school because they expecting them to have direct contact with me, not just in the school, but in the instructional classroom.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to be the black history teacher. I must have that. I'm going to be the political science teacher as well. They will get that from me. And I will probably be the African spirituality teacher, although I will have adjunct priests and priestesses coming to assist with that. But I want to give them as much of me as they possibly can. And before school even start, we go out into the woods. Before school even start, we start our rites of passage. Mm-hmm. Before school even start, we out there with manhood training in the bush, that's learning how to live off the land, learning how to purify your water, mm-hmm. learning how to set up your defense grounds. We are going to make sure that they're ready for class before class even start.
That's right. Now, I was just thinking, so, and that's for young...